Brothers and sisters, please welcome to the stage your special guest speaker, stand-up comedian, Tez Ilyas! My name is Tez Ilyas, and welcome to Tez Talks, the how-to guide to being a British Muslim. This series is for everyone interested in Muslims, or indeed interested in becoming a Muslim. Hashtag radical. And I, of course, use the word radical in the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle sense of the word, as in, you're becoming Muslim? Totally radical, dude. Now, this series is for everyone. It's especially for those of you who are actively thinking about converting to Islam. And I know all you potential converts, or as you'll be called going forward, Muslims 2.0. You want more information before you can think about making such a big commitment. You'll have questions, difficult questions, like, will I be able to keep my nectar points if I convert? I get it. So that's what Tez Talks is. It's to answer the barrage, or friendly fire, if you will, of questions. Questions about Islamic life in the UK. BTW, the answer is no to nectar points, but yes to chilies on your Nando's card. Before we start, I thought it'd be good for you to get to know who I am. Three things. I am a British national Pakistani, or BNP for short, of course. I'm from Blackburn. The San Francisco of England. What? We have a bridge. And thirdly, I was bullied as a kid for being nerdy and a bit overweight. Look at me now. Obviously, you can't see me at home, but the audience tonight, I'm sure, will testify that basically, I am an Asian Ryan Gosling. So each of these talks covers an aspect of British Muslim life, and the topic for this week's talk is integration. Now, integration is a word you hear a lot as a Muslim in this country. Some people are like, how can we help Muslims integrate better? Bit patronizing, but it's better than the other lot who'd be like, how can we help Muslims integrate back to Muslimistan? Generally, we Muslims in the UK have done a pretty solid job of integration, and nowhere is that more evident than our success in the mainstream media. Because if you are listening by accident, and you don't actually know that much about us Muslims, then you might recognize us from that hit TV show, The News. Because we have been on that one a lot this series, haven't we? Like, we've got recurring characters, it's on our prime time. Now, I suspect by now that many of you who've chosen to listen to this are getting increasingly tempted to convert to Islam. You're thinking, I want me some of that awesome press coverage too. But for those of you who do convert, how will you integrate your new Muslim identity into life in Britain? Well, there was a poll conducted a couple of months ago for a Channel 4 show with Trevor Phillips, the former head of the Equality Commission, in which he basically concluded that Muslims, we aren't like the rest of the population. Apparently, we have a problem integrating. He genuinely said that. And look, my initial instinct was to get mad and defensive and to issue a fatwa against him. But then I thought, no, that's what he wants. So I thought about what he said, and I thought, maybe he has a point. So I've been searching around for some tips on how we Muslims can integrate better into Britain. Well, quite helpfully, Commander Mac Chishti of the Metropolitan Police Service, the country's most senior Muslim police officer, and so obviously automatically an expert on such matters, he was interviewed in The Guardian, and in the interview, the commander said that Muslims, we need to be more vigilant in spotting the signs of extremism in our own communities. Cool. A bit of self-policing. Respect my authority. You know what? I'll do it. I'm in. Now, what should we be looking out for? And the commander said, and I quote, questions should be asked if someone stops shopping at Marks and Spencer. What does that extremist even look like? Because this is not just any extremist. No, this is an ISIS-loving, M&S boycotting, best of British extremists. Now, if there's any of you who don't know where that reference is from, then you're part of the problem. This leads on to a bigger point about integration, the importance of upholding the law. Now, for those of you that do decide you want to convert, you may well be part of a minority group for the very first time in your lives. And the downside is, if you break the law, it reflects badly on all of us. And I think I do blame the media for this. For example, if you get a handful of illegal immigrants who might misbehave, you get headlines like this one from the Sunday Times.
Europe needs an integration test for Muslim immigrants.
Or, if a few people misjudge a poll, you end up with...
1 in 5 Brit Muslims, sympathy for jihadis.
But, to be fair, if things go really wrong, then the papers do quite rightly jump in with journalistic exposés, such as this one from The Sun.
The halal secret of Pizza Express.
A genuine front-page headline. Regardless, it's really important to actually respect British law because some people, they really believe that Muslims want to implement Sharia law in Britain. I'd like to correct this misconception in a calm and thoughtful feature on the show. My producer has insisted that this fact-checking section should have a jingle to stop it sounding boring. His words. But I've asked for it to be low-key and non-sensationalist. So, here we go.
Truth bomb!
Are you serious? I thought I told you I wanted this bit to be called Tez's Pearls of Wisdom and he's handsome. Something like that, you know, just something. Can we keep the jingles bomb-free? Anyway, the truth of the matter is Muslims don't want to implement Sharia law in Britain. The Sharia is actually the moral and religious code by which Muslims follow their faith. It's not about imposing a law on people who don't follow Islam. Like, for example, just because you're vegan doesn't mean you want everyone else to be... Oh, no, that's a bad example. That's a really bad example. I don't know if you're aware of this, right? The vegan club is actually the direct opposite of Fight Club. In that the first rule of vegan club is tell everyone about vegan club. And the second rule of vegan club is tell everyone about vegan club. And then the third rule of vegan club is don't eat meat. Anyway, undeterred by the Sharia fact, I heard one chap from the highly credible-sounding organisation, you may have heard of them, Britain First, top lads. Their spokesman said a few months ago, there should only be one law for everyone in Britain. Everyone in Britain should follow one law. And I was like, damn right they should, until I looked it up. And I'm not sure if you're aware of this. It actually turns out that there's thousands of laws in Britain. So I thought, which one should a good British Muslim uphold? Well, I've done my research, and maybe one of these genuine existing laws is the one law that Britain First want us to follow. No person shall import into England potatoes which he knows or suspects to be Polish. I didn't say it was going to be easy. So, if that one's too hard, then maybe try and uphold this law. It is an offence to be intoxicated and in charge of a cow in Scotland. What did they do? I mean, is that what independence actually all about? Well, don't tell us what we can do with our coups. All right. One of the key things to integrating effectively is to be confident. Luckily, we have so many amazing Muslim role models to look up to in the West, right? So I've asked the audience in the room to give me an example of their favourite Western Muslim role model before they entered the room, and they've written them down for me. I've got to be honest, there were some pretty hopeless efforts. There were a lot of blanks. There were a few, so I'll read some out. Omid Jalili, Christopher, is Christopher here? Christopher, did you write Omid Jalili?
Yes.
Good effort, it's wrong, but... just Iranian, so not all brown people are Muslim. Next one. Who wrote Salman Rushdie? It's a different game. Oh, here we go. Sadiq Khan. Sadiq Khan.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.